What's going on, YouTube? My name is FG3000. I'm back in the place to be, and welcome to the closed beta of CounterSide. Now, I know there's a little bit of confusion out there. Some people were like, FG, didn't this game come out like a year and a half ago? Yes, it did, but that was the SEA version. This is the global version. It's different. So let's go ahead and jump on in and see what sets CounterSide apart from all the other gacha games currently on the market. So combat here in CounterSide is comprised of 8-unit squads, already on FG's good side. But it gets better. You can also bring a ship or a base or a nexus, whatever you want to call it. You got one of them too. Not to mention in this game, you also have non-humanoid heroes. You have like drones and helicopters and trucks. You guys know I'm a big proponent of games having non-humanoid heroes that you can collect. It don't get more non-humanoid than a truck, B. A truck! Now, when it comes to combat here in CounterSide, it follows a very familiar formula where you have a shared resource meter that builds up points over time. You can then use those points to summon heroes. Once you summon those heroes, they jump out on the battlefield with basic attacks, on summon abilities, passives, active skills, and of course, ultimates. But now here is where the counterplay in CounterSide comes into action. You see what I did there? Yes, FG, we see what you did there. We've been playing the game for a year and a half. We've been new. So let's dive a little deeper into that counterplay, shall we? So this game does follow a traditional elemental weakness system, but it is thematic for CounterSide. So instead of like water and fire, you have defenders and snipers. So if your opponent has a ton of snipers on their side, maybe you start summoning a bunch of defenders on your side, but your defenders are kind of low DPS, so maybe you hold some of your resource points so you can summon a defender plus a sniper at the same exact time. That's just one level of counterplay, but then there's even more, right? Let's say your opponent has a bunch of flying units and all of your units can't attack flyers. So now you're in the situation where you're scrambling, trying to make sure that you summon units that can not only counter the flying units, but also counter their class type. And you can kind of see, like, just based off of that really crude example, that this game is all about on the fly, in the moment thinking, which lends itself extremely well to live PvP. I think a lot of people might even say that this game's crowning achievement when it comes to gameplay is its live PvP, and I would not argue. I've had a ton of fun playing live PvP in this game, and I don't know nothing. So the fact that I clearly know that I'm missing so much nuance in the combat here in CounterSide just makes me really excited to actually get my hands on this game once it hits global launch, to like really deep dive into the skills and the passives and the counters. Dude, gamer mode is about to be activated. So with all that talk of PvP, I know that's not exactly everyone's cup of tea, but I think this game kind of treads the line quite well. It appeals to the lazy FGs out there and the gamer mode FGs out there as well. So strategy battle is all automated. There is no manual gameplay whatsoever. Your automated team versus an opponent's automated team. That's easy. That's pretty carefree. And then, of course, there's ranked battle, aka live PvP. And this is where you can let your gamer mode shine. Now, of course, this is not going to be for everyone, but as far as I can see, most of the items in the PvP shop can all be purchased with one form of currency, with an exception. So you shouldn't feel like you're missing out on too much if you really don't like live PvP. Now, some of my longtime viewers might be like, FG, you never start a video off with PvP. Something's mighty fishy. You're right. So let's talk about the campaign flow. Now, stick with me through the entire thing. There's a lot to say about this. FG hates this grid, chessboard style nonsense. You know what I'm talking about. The same type of campaigns that you've seen in games like Azura Lane, Blue Archive, and not to mention Super Strike. And I'm so conflicted because you guys know FG loves to have big, massive rosters. Look at this. I got 3 ships filled with 8 units a pop, being able to jump into combat this early in the game's life. Dude, you love to see. However, this type of gameplay, I've just noticed over the years of playing these gacha games, you know, they're novel at the beginning, but the more and more you do them, the more tedious they feel. Not to mention, developers that make these types of systems go out of their way to add tedium to the systems. There's always like some weird arbitrary 3-star requirement where you gotta do 3 of this or 4 of that, or move around 8 times, wiggle and swing, like all these things that are added to these campaign stages. And I'm like, dude, just give me stage 1, 1, 1, 2, and 1, 3. I'm talking to you once again, Super Strang. However, with all that being said, I am absolutely blown away by CounterSide. What you talking about, FG? Well, in the Korean version of this game, they are removing the entire chessboard grid system from the game in its entirety. And that game upgrade will soon be making its way to SEA, and then of course will soon be making its way to global. So when this game does come out to global, we're gonna have to put up with it for a little while. But dude, I am blown away that a developer is opting to remove a system that is this intertwined into their game, based off of player feedback. Now, I know absolutely nothing about the overall track record of the developer behind CounterSide, Studio B-Side, but let me tell you, they're already on FG's good side. Now, let old FG tell you something that you already know. I have begged for years and years for other game studios to remove bad gameplay modes from their game. I'm looking at you, Linda Lightbringer, Heir of Light, but they have just like blatantly refused to do so because they're like, yo, we spent development time and resources to make this gameplay mode. We're not gonna remove it. And I feel like it's such a bad move. Yeah, as a player, you can just ignore bad gameplay modes, but you know how us gacha game players are. Dude, we gotta min-max. We gotta play all the gameplay modes to get all the rewards. And if you have a really awful gameplay mode or, you know, some type of tedious system in your game, over time, it's just gonna burn out your players. It's not worth it. Just remove it, retool it, redesign it, do something, right? And I'm like racking my brain. I'm like really thinking hard. I literally can't think of any game in the history of gachadom outside of like 2.0 relaunches and things like that where a game studio has removed a tedious gameplay feature that is this intertwined in their game. Like, I can't think of one. So for that fact alone, dude, I'm gonna be there day one global launch. I am like the number one fanboy of Studio B-Side just off of that fact alone. And of course, you know, FG loves a little bit of futuristic and fantasy. Gate 6, I miss you. So let's quickly run through all of the different gameplay modes here in CounterSide. There is a lot of game here. So mainstream, that's gonna be your main campaign mode, normal and hard modes. Next up is supply operation, which is gonna be your tried and true daily resource grind. And speaking of daily resource grinds, CounterSide has skips without the tickets, baby. You love to see. Next up is simulation, which is also a daily resource grind, but this is gonna be limited per day. You have side story, which is basically side stories for individual characters. You have challenge mode, where you have to defeat content with the restricted number of units. Counter cases, which gives you even more background information on some of your favorite characters. Free contracts that I just unlocked, so I'm not gonna talk about. And then events, which will be coming soon. And then of course, what game would be complete without a tried and true dispatch mode where you can send your units out on missions. They come back in 1 hour, 4 hours, or 8 hours with all types of goodies in tow. Now, if you're sitting there blown away like, ah, gee, that sure is a lot of gameplay. You're right, but there's more. How about a labyrinth mode? As you go from node to node, defeating encounters, getting artifacts, increasing the power of your squad as you defeat harder content. Or how about RNG summon raid bosses, Marvel Future Fight style, where you gotta bring 24 units to combat and you're still not gonna win, so you gotta summon some of your guildmates or your friends to help you finish it off. Dude, CounterSide is looking like the truth. Also, dorms. You got dorms. So that is a look at CounterSide. So much to cover. We're definitely gonna revisit this game once it hits global launch, but let's end this video off as we always do with a nice little summon session. We'll do the full summon animation. Then of course, we're gonna go rapid fire style. Let's go ahead and pull down the hatch. This is looking good. SSRs. So we should get some SSRs here. I really enjoy the art, even on the normal unit rarity. They look good. Live 2D all across the board. Like I said, a nice blend between fantasy and futuristic. You love to see. I already have a copy of her, so I wanna see if we can get somebody new. But that was an SSR pool. We have Husbandos as well, not to fear. Is this who I think it is, Lee Defoe? Ah, no. I was looking for the guy that has a Tokyo Ghoul mask. He's supposed to be a pretty decent tank. I got an SSR pool. I'm not mad about that. I just have her already as a dupe and I'm not currently using her. Let's see what else we can get. Lots of Husbando units, not to mention non-humanoid units, which of course I love to see. Tanks, helicopters, drones, trucks. I've never seen such a thing and I'm really appreciative of a game daring to put something in their game other than just waifus. But you know FG love good waifu, you know what I'm talking about. Dude, Ingrid got some abs. Oh, Lee Jin. This is my first time getting her. All right, so this is the guy I was talking about. Defender Ogami Masaki. He has a nice little bootleg Tokyo Ghoul mask. All right, let's level this guy up. All right, so let's use Ogambi to break down the upgrade process here in CounterSide. Leveling up is kind of goofy, right? So just like in most games, you feed your character some EXP juice, they level up, very straightforward. However, in this game, they're not really called levels, it's called a salary negotiation. So that's me on the left. I'm like a bootleg PlayStation 3. And I have to offer a salary to Ogami here to get more loyalty out of him, to get more levels out of him. And then there's an RNG chance that it could succeed or fail. I don't know. I thought it was kind of cool and creative to begin with, but I would be okay with just good old fashioned leveling. So the limit break system has two parts. You can limit break using duplicates like you do in most games, but you can also limit break using materials. And word is on the street, you want to focus on limit breaking with materials first and then start limit breaking with your dupes later on when you're at the later star levels. But once again, I'm brand new. What do I know? And then there's skill training, which allows you to train your skills. And as you guys can see, as you go up in levels, you also activate additional passives as well. And as you might expect, there's going to be certain units in this game that are okay on their own, but really come to life once you start adding two or three more skill point upgrades and certain abilities, which makes me really excited for the team building aspect of CounterSide. And then, of course, to go along with your in-game grind of PvP, you have a nice little in-game grind of equipment as well. So more to come on that. I haven't even really touched the surface when it comes to equipment, but yeah, be on the lookout. So that will do it. A nice little look at the closed beta of CounterSide. This is my number one game in 2022 that I didn't even know I wanted. So looking forward to global launch, and I'll see you then.